Ever wonder how to manage your events at scale? Azure Event Grid is the solution, and I'm going to tell you all about it coming up now. Hello, everybody. My name is Adam Gordon, an entertainer here at ITProTV, back with another exciting and fun-filled episode in our What is Azure Conversation series. We're continuing to look at different Azure services, features, and capabilities that are going to be of interest to you and that you want to know more about. In this episode, we're going to take a look at Azure Event Grid. And as we always do, we'll pose and answer our three famous questions. What is Event Grid? Why would you want to use it? And of course, how do we roll our sleeves up and actually put this thing to work? Let's jump right in and start talking about what Event Grid actually is. On the left-hand side of the light board over here, you see that I've documented out and kind of drawn out a column that's labeled Event Sources. And Event Sources really just represents all the different events. Events are things that happen that we want to be able to understand and ultimately work with and use Event Grid to help us to work with. But Event Sources are the things that actually create those events. So we've got a whole bunch of them, randomly sampling some of the different event sources that potentially can be used to interact with Event Grid. We have Event Grid over here in the middle. This is obviously going to be very important, which is why it's sitting between our two columns. More on that in just a second. And over here on the right, we have what's known as event handlers. And again, we have a sampling of different event handlers. Event handlers are going to be the things that receive information about events and that can then go execute on that information and do something on our behalf. And so what we're really looking at is things that happen, elements that are going to take those things that happen and create some action, and something in the middle that really becomes central to our conversation because it has to connect the things that are creating events to the things that are going to act on those events. And that's what Event Grid really does. It creates connections for us, taking information, events produce information, and allowing us to transfer that at scale, globally across the Azure infrastructure, anywhere across any data center, potentially in the world. Highly available, it's always there, always on, and as always, we pay for only what we need and what we consume. And as a matter of fact, we actually get our first 100,000 event occurrences free as we use Event Grid as part of our default standard Azure subscription. So the first 100,000 events that occur every month are just going to flow through this process. We're not even going to pay for them. We like that a lot. So when we think about event sources, we think about things that are happening. And when we want to answer the question, what is Event Grid? It really is, at the end of the day, it's either, you could think of it as a switchboard operator, if you have that point of reference in your mind, or as I was talking with one of my colleagues here at ITProTV, she said to me, hey, that sounds kind of like a router. It's moving information from one place and sending it to another. You could think of it like that. Whatever makes the most sense to you, it is this central element that allows us to take these events that are occurring, process them, and then send them over into these various areas that are going to take action on our behalf. It becomes the central switching station for all of our information flow. That's really what Azure Event Grid is all about. Now, when we think about the why would we want to use Event Grid? Why do we need to take all these event sources, things from Azure resource groups, our containing elements that have all of our objects in them, the Azure subscription or subscriptions we may have, the all-up wrapper, the all-up entity that contains everything we do, all the things we've been talking about in our conversations, other event hubs, other elements that process events, or any of the services and capabilities that can create event sources. There are an almost unlimited number of them in Azure. Why would we want to move that information through a central mechanism to process it and then send it over to one or more of these event handlers? Things that can take that input and do something on our behalf. Perhaps some sort of serverless code that's running as one or more Azure functions. Web apps that can provide capabilities. Workflow and integration that can take this event and trigger an entire outcome chain, an entire process chain somewhere else in the Azure service stack. Buffering and the ability to be able to consume additional events through event hubs. A paired companion with Event Grid that lets us execute on these events and essentially be able to tee them up for different workflow elements and all sorts of other services and applications that are being fed these events to allow them to then do their job on our behalf. The why, in other words, is really the valuable power of scale here that lets us take outcomes that are occurring somewhere in our system, consistently, reliably transfer them to inbound receptors, things that are going to take them on and ultimately take action for us on our behalf, moving that event down the chain, enabling us at scale to not only create the interactions and ultimately create the outcomes we look for, but to really enable us to utilize fully all the different services and capabilities in the Azure platform, many of which we've already talked about in our conversations, and of course, many more that will be upcoming as we continue looking at different Azure services. So when we think about the why, really think about event management and event communication at scale, highly available, highly scalable globally, anywhere from anywhere to anywhere across our Azure infrastructure. Now, as we step back and really think about the why and the what, that always takes us towards the how. And when we think about the how, as we always do, we will go in and normally take a look at how to implement one of these services, showing you, at least on the surface, at a high level, what it takes to stand this up. Event Grid's a little different in this respect. It's a very complicated solution to initially stand up, not because it's hard to do, but because there's a lot of moving parts associated with creating this seemingly very simple and straightforward element, right, that sits between our occurrences and our ability to communicate them for action. So the idea of being able to show it to you really just unfortunately is not going to fit into our normal how demo as we normally will walk through that at the end of our conversation. But rest assured, we're still going to answer your how question for you, but instead of showing it to you here, I'm going to invite you to join me over at ITProTV, take a look at more in-depth conversations that I have around how to set up Event Grid in many of these Azure services. And if you need that level of detail and really want to see me walk through it end to end, you can always check me out over there and you could see me along with all my colleagues show you all the different things you want to know. I'm going to wish you happy Azuring until I see you again with another conversation. And remember, no matter how easy or complex it is, we'll always be here to explain it to you.